Now, as a chef, sometimes we take ingredients for granted, but here is the king of all ingredients of Italy. It's the Amalfi lemon.
Amalfi lemons are iconic to this area. They date back to Roman times, and today they're still farmed in the traditional way, with every single one picked by hand. Here at the Villa Maria farmhouse, they have their own lemon groves. Vincenzo Ruoco's family have farmed here for generations, and along with his wife Maria, they now also run a guest house and restaurant. Maria does all the cooking, while Vincenzo looks after the lemons, which are harvested from February to October.
Amalfi Coast, because if you crush lemon...
Lots of juice.
Yeah, lot of juice.
The lemons here are known for their intense flavour and juiciness, which I'm looking forward to putting to the test with my first dish.
Now, to give justice to these lemons, I thought I'd go to France. I know it's a bit of a swear word in Italy, but I'm gonna do a simple little crepe suzette souffle. But using the lemons, they use lemons and oranges, but you can use either or. But first of all, we're gonna make a pancake batter. It's eggs, flour, milk. Easy as that. Now, I always think the temptation with pancakes is to mess around and flipping it around. Just leave it in the pan. That way it'll colour just slightly on the bottom and then it's ready to then turn over. Flip it over. We're now ready to simply make our sauce. We can actually make our sauce in this pan. And to do that, I need some caster sugar and we're gonna caramelise this. And while that's caramelising, look at that. Fresh Amalfi lemons. I'm just gonna slice these nice and thin. I'm gonna serve the whole lot, rind on it and everything. I think you get so much flavor out of the lemon rind, particularly over here. They just taste different to any lemon you've probably ever tasted. And they were telling me earlier, they actually just put salt on it and serve it in a nice salad with some parsley and some seafood. It's wonderful. They're not sharp, they're just almost like tasting lemonade, delicious.
For a double lemony hit, I'm using the region's most famous lemon liqueur, limoncello, and it's made from the rinds of lemons, and Vincenzo makes his own on site. Once the caramel is a deep golden brown colour, it's ready for a generous measure.
Limoncello in. Flame it. Watching his lemon trees. These lemon pieces and a good squeeze of lemon juice. And this is where the Amalfi lemons really come into their own. The amount of juice you get out of here, it's almost like a glass per lemon. We incorporate all that together and instantly it cooks our lemon on here. Easy as that. Now to enrich it and to flavour it even more, I'll put a little knob of butter in there, just to finish it all off. Now, I wouldn't do this normally, but nobody's looking. That is magical. Magical, magical.
To make these extra special, I'm adding a souffle filling of whisked egg whites, lemon zest, ready-made custard, and sugar. Once folded together, it's ready to go into my pancakes.
Now what you want to do is divide this pancake into quarters. Place some of your souffle mixture on one side, fold it over, and then fold it over again. Now ideally what you want to do is bake it in the oven at this point. What I'm doing is just pan frying them in there. Just cover them with the lid. I'm going to cook those for about a couple of minutes. So just to serve these, we've got our sauce ready. Now these will actually souffle up as they're cooking. And then you've got your nice sauce. So just some fresh basil leaves. Rather than just use the stereotypical mint, have a go at doing this. It tastes so good, but it needs to be put in at the last minute. So quick mix together, pour it over the top of your pancakes. Lemon ice cream. Well, while Vincenzo's the boss on the farm, it's definitely Maria. And your beautiful sister? What's your sister's name?
Margherita.
Margherita.
Yes.
Basically, they're the proper cooks of the house. Every day, she makes pasta and the most beautiful food. We ate here last night, me and the crew, and it was one of the best meals I've had on my travels. It was just superb.
Another favourite pasta here is fusilli, which Maria and her sister painstakingly hand-roll. The secret, they tell me, is to make sure that the pasta isn't too thick like a dumpling or too thin as it tastes of nothing. And I'm going to use this fresh pasta for my next recipe, along with some vegetables they grow here.
What I'm going to do is do a simple little pasta dish. We've got some great vegetables from the garden. We've got some lovely beans, courgettes, a little bit of basil. I'm going to use that to create a little paste with, of course, some of the famous lemons.
First, make a basil paste by breaking the leaves down with some salt in a pestle and mortar.
We can add some olive oil. And some more basil. I have to say, in all my travels and all my years of trying to get basil and herbs and things growing in the garden, I've never seen basil like this. Just a huge leaf. It almost looks like a big leaf of sorrel. I mean, look at the size of that sort of stuff. And it smells so pungent as well. So after it's mixed, you get this lovely, really dark green colour. It just creates this lovely green paste, which is what we want to use, and we want to finish off our dish with that.
Next, chop up the green beans and put them into a double boiler so they can cook at the same time as the pasta. Because the pasta is freshly made, it only takes a few minutes to cook.
So lid on, bring that to the boil, and literally strain it off straight away.
As it cooks, there's just time to chop up my courgette.
But all we're going to do is lightly cook our pasta. That's ready now. So now we can finish it off and incorporate this all into our sauce. And to do that, I'm going to add our courgette straight in the pan. Just a bit of crushed garlic, and to do that, we just grab some salt, crush them with the back of the knife, just to break it up. Gonna add some of this pasta water. This is where we're gonna make an emulsion and a sauce to go with everything else. So at this point, when you've got the water in, place your garlic in. We can then grab the rest of our ingredients here, add it all into our pan. More of this pasta water. And then we can add a nice paste. And this is where you start to get all that lovely flavour. And to create a nice little sauce, what I do is add some butter to it. Add our Parmesan cheese.
A little seasoning and a squeeze of lemon.
I can pour that over the top and create a little lemon flower. When you slice that, just a touch of basil. Sprinkle that over the top. A drizzle of homemade olive oil.